Sort of moving forward onto this year's, this past season's Gales team, you know, what were some of the similarities you saw in your Sweet 16 run to this year's team? What are some of the differences? Can you talk to us a little bit about that?
I think that there's more of a team this year. It's really balanced, and, you know, you never knew who was going to step up and play for you or play well, and you guys were really good this year just as a team, and I think the biggest thing you guys did was come together, like watching on TV and stuff, and you guys were excited for each other, high fives, all that kind of stuff, and that's what wins, you know, so I was really proud of this team, obviously, and it was fun to see the other guys, like, on Twitter and stuff, guys who used to play here, Daniel Kicker, Diamond, Patty, whoever it may be, like, tweeting, like, about to go watch the game, you know, Mickey, it's 4 a.m., Mickey's awake in Italy watching the game, so it was definitely cool to rally around you guys and great to see the things you guys accomplished.
Definitely. I know you have a lot ahead of you, so can you talk to us a little bit about, you know, your future plans, you know, some of the things you...
Yeah, well, I want to get into broadcasting. That's why I took this class. And, like, actually during the lockout, I got a chance to do some courtside games for college and whatnot, so it was fun. And then I've done, like, post-game, NBA post-games and stuff, so... I think moving forward, I'll definitely move over to that side. I want to play for a few more years, so I'll do that first, hopefully, as long as I can stay healthy. But, yeah, I want to move into broadcasting after.
We have one more call.
My name's Ryan Rinichetti. Just a question, moving on from St. Mary's onto professional. I'm sure you get to experience a lot of things traveling around. I know you've done some traveling in different places, different teams. Can you just tell us about some of those experiences you've had while you've been traveling around in the pros?
Yeah. I have the worst agent ever. I love that. He's actually a really good agent. But he sent me to Eastern Europe, which I didn't know. I'm not, like, a world traveler. I've never really left the East Bay before, except for, like, a game. So I went to Eastern Europe for 7 months, and I got off the plane in some Jordan shorts and some shoes, and it was just white powder everywhere, like, just snow everywhere. It was the worst thing ever. So our team was sponsored by Audi, and on the second day, we got brand new R8s. Sick. So I'm doing what any rookie who just got a new R8 would do and just smashing this thing. Like, I'm driving this thing to the ground. And I've never driven in snow before because I'm a California kid. And apparently, you know, it doesn't... So I came around the corner kind of quick, and I totaled my R8 the second day I got it. And that was, like, a rough start to my career, but it was, like, a funny story now. So, yeah, Lithuania was interesting. It was cold, and... The biggest thing is, when you travel abroad, it's hard to really see other people's culture in 2 weeks. When you're there for 10 months, or maybe sometimes 2 years, you kind of are really embracing the culture, and that's, like, the greatest part about it is you get to see so many different places in the world and stuff. I mean, the NBA is great, and obviously that's everybody's goal to play in it, but there's a lot to be said for, you know, playing overseas and getting to see different cultures and countries, so it was a lot of fun. And I was on a EuroLeague team, so we got to go to Italy and France and, you know, everywhere. So it was awesome. Eiffel Tower, you know, going to see those things is amazing because you grew up reading about them or hearing about them. So seeing them in person, anybody who travels abroad knows what I'm talking about. So it was awesome. Good experience.
Thank you.